Your Android lets you do multiple tasks like communicating with contacts, organizing your contact list, managing apps, manipulating files, and many more. Yet, managing your Android device can also easily get in the way of productivity if you're working on your computer and you frequently pick up your phone or tablet just to reply to messages. Thankfully, there are solutions such as ARDC, AirDroid, Visor, and many more. ARDC is a free Windows application that can help you with displaying and controlling your Android device on the PC. In this guide, I'll be getting into how to set up the ARDC and all it can offer. ARDC is an acronym which stands for Android Remote Displayer and Controller. It's free and its file size is very small, and as a freemium-based Windows application, it comes with no ads. ARDC displays your phone screen over to your computer screen and lets you control your Android device using just your USB cable or Wi-Fi. A desktop computer, notebook, or netbook. Unlike many other wireless solutions or remote managers for Android, ARDC doesn't need you to install additional companion software on your Android device because you can access ARDC directly from any Windows PC. An Android device being a phone or a tablet. USB cable. Your phone's USB cable connection serves as the pathway between ARDC on your computer and your Android device, but you can then go further by activating its wire-free access after. Download ARDC from the link below and place it anywhere you want. I will place mine on the desktop as there is no installer file and therefore needs no installation. The first time you run ARDC, the app will prompt you with a message stating that you don't have ADB installed. ADB is an acronym which stands for Android Debug Bridge and is a tool that Google actually offers for developers to debug various parts of their application. Download ADB from the link below, open the ADB folder, copy and paste all the files into the ARDC folder. We can now run ARDC just to make sure it doesn't have the ADB error. Launch the settings application on your phone. Tap the About Phone option, generally near the bottom of the list. This is hidden behind the System option in Google's latest 8.0 version. Tap the build number option 7 times to enable developer mode. You will see a toast message when it's done. Now go back to the main settings screen and you should see a new developer option menu you can access. Go in there and enable the USB debugging mode option. Change the USB mode to file transfer MTP mode. Launch the ARDC application and connect your smartphone or tablet to your computer with a USB cable. ARDC should then connect to your Android device with no error. Click the File tab on the menu bar and select Device Window, or you can use the shortcut key Alt-D to get it in view. With your Android device already connected, click on the Wi-Fi tab and wait for confirmation. You can then remove the USB cable and ARDC should be still working. Dragging any file onto the ARDC interface saves it directly to the download folder, and this makes it a very fast way of transferring files between your PC and your Android device. Capture screenshots. Record your screen. And you also have access to a lot of Android power user stuff like the ADB commands and many more. The only real downside I encountered with ARDC is audio. Audio will not route from your Android device to your PC, even though every other thing is, meaning that you will still be hearing audio from your Android device and not the PC. You would have to gain a one-time connection to ARDC using the USB cable before you can activate its Wi-Fi solution, but after that, you're good to go. It only supports Windows platforms. Do you use ARDC to remotely manage your Android device? What do you like most about the application? And what missing features or functions would you like to see in ARDC future updates? If you guys want me to get into details as to how to use the ARDC client, share your thoughts in the comment section. And as always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys on the next one. Peace.